Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Kankana's Health Forum. Today I am here with you to talk about 7 tips how we can improve our sleep and how we can treat our insomnia without medication. So before starting the video, if you are new to my channel, kindly subscribe to my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon so that whenever I upload a new video, you'll get notified. So now let's start the video. Nowadays, we can see that insomnia is a very common problem in our generation. So, in studies also, we can see that 1/3 of the individual have sleep problem once in a lifetime. Maintenance of sleep is very important. Why? Because if we are unable to sleep, not only psychological problem will occur, but also we can see some physiological problems too. Many of you wants to know about the causes of insomnia. So, there are lots of causes. So I want to give you an idea very shortly. First one will be your alcohol or drug use is the also one primary cause of insomnia, as well as if there is any psychiatric disorder, this one is also leads to insomnia. And some social causes like divorce, or if there is any marriage problem, so those are also social causes that triggers this insomnia. And some behavioral problems like nap during the daytime, or lack of physical exercise, or if there is irregular sleeping pattern. So these are some causes that triggers insomnia. So us, firstly, we have to see that how without medication we can treat insomnia. So that's why I am here with you to share 7 tips how we can improve our sleep pattern. So let's start from the number 1 point, and that is comfortable environment. So whenever you are going to sleep, your room should be cool and calm. That means here research says that there should be 3 points in a comfortable environment. That is, your room should be dark, your room should be clean, and your room should be cool. So these 3 points you have to remember so that you can make a comfortable environment to sleep, and your sleep pattern or your sleep quality will improve. Now we are coming to the second point, that is physical exercise. So you can do your physical exercise either in the morning time or in the afternoon time, but do not do your exercise before your sleep hours or like in the evening time, because it will hamper your sleep pattern. And if you do your exercise in the morning or your afternoon time, it will help in sleep induction. And here also timing is important. You can do your exercise 15 to 30 minutes every day. And if you do like this every day, then it will help you to improve your sleep pattern, as well as you can get rid of insomnia. Now we are coming to the third point, that is avoid coffee, tea, cola drinks, etc. Why? Because it contains caffeine, and you should not take more fluid intake after 7 p.m. because it will interrupt in your sleep pattern. So you have to always remember that before sleeping hours, you should always avoid caffeine intake. Now we are coming to the fourth point, that is food. You have to always remember that before sleeping hours, you should always take light meal. Here is a very interesting fact that I want to share with you, is you can take warm milk before sleeping hours. Why? Because it contains tryptophan, which is a sleep promoting substance, and that will help you to increase your sleep pattern. That's why warm milk is very effective if you are taking before your sleeping hours. It will improve your sleep quality. Now let's come to the number 5th point, that is stimulus control therapy. Here what we have to do is that do not use the bed for reading or chatting. Go to bed only for sleeping. Why? Because our brain should also get the signal what is the use of the bed. If you have severe problems of sleeping disturbance, then you can consult your psychiatrist or psychologist, because in psychology there are lots of therapies like light therapy, cognitive behavioral therapy, and among them stimulus control therapy is also one of them that you can use. That's why I told you that do not use your bed for any kind of work like reading, chatting, or anything. Use your bed only for sleeping, which will help you to improve your sleep pattern. And one more important thing that you have to remember is that go to bed whenever you feel sleepy. Other than that, do not use your bed. Now we are coming to the 6th point, that is meditation, yoga, and your sleep pattern, means our sleep cycle. So if you are doing meditation in yoga. I have already made one video on meditation yoga in the stress management video. You can watch that and you can get how we can do meditation in a proper environment. What are the steps to do meditations? So everything is there. So you can see there in that video, in my previous video. And the sleeping time or sleeping hours means if you are sleeping at the night time at 10 p.m. you have to always fix that timing at the next for the next day also. And if you are waking up at 5 a.m. at the next day also, you should wake up at the 5 a.m. only. So like this, your brain will also know that at what time you are going to sleep and at what time you are going to wake up. So if you maintain this timing, then it will help you to improve your quality of sleep. Coming to the seventh point, that is medication. Though I told you that without medicine how we can improve our sleep pattern, but if these 6 points are not working for you for so long, then you can take your medicine if necessary and you can consult your doctor. And without consulting your doctor, do not take any medication because it might be harmful for your body. So you need to remember this. So these are some 7 ways how we can improve our sleep pattern and how we can get rid of insomnia. If you really like my videos, then kindly like, share and subscribe. And if you want to know any topic or anything related to health, let me know in the comment section below. Or if you want to suggest me or if you want to give any feedback related to my videos, then you are always welcome. And if you think that my videos are helpful for you all, then let me know with a thumbs up so that I'll get more encouragement and motivation to make more videos for you. And till then, thank you so much.